All right, Matt, really interesting fight coming at us at lightweight between Benny and the Jets. Benil Dariush, people don't like my singing. People don't like my jokes. Listen, you're in it for some of it, so stick around. And we've got Scott Hot Sauce Holtzman. It's a great nickname, and he picked up a really big win his last fight over Jim Miller. Judges scoring it 29-28, 29-28, 30-27. It was one of those fight of the night type performances out of Hot Sauce. And he's a guy that so far in the UFC, he's fought some all right competition. He's lost to some bigger names. He's beaten some names that you might recognize, but might not be around anymore. For Benny and the Jets, I can go through some of the wins, but it's insane. He has wins over Rocco Martin, Carlos Diego Fajeya, Darren Cruikshank, Jim Miller, Michael Johnson, James Vick, Rashid Magomedov. And then it didn't go all that great. Well, he lost to Barboza, had a draw against Evan Dunham. And then he lost to Hernandez, where he got knocked out, and that was a short notice one that put Alexander Hernandez on the map. But the win since, Thiago Moises, Drew Dober, where he submitted him, Frank Camacho submits him, and he knocks out Jakar Close in a fight that, again, I don't think I ever want to see again, and I feel bad for Jakar Close and Courtney Casey. So we look at how this one sets up. Benil Dariush, Matt, is a frustrating fighter because I think the ceiling is like he could be a champion tomorrow. He has all the parts and parcels. It's just he has one flaw that we've seen exposed so far in the UFC.
Benil Dariush's skill for skill is as good as anybody in the UFC. And people might get upset at me saying that, but if you actually watch his fights and analyze what he is doing, he is absurd. And the Jakar Close fight is interesting because you look at, okay, KO overhand left. A lot of people remember that crazy sequence. He gets clipped, moves backwards, Close comes in, he cracks him, moves forward, drops him with a walk-off KO.
Oh, yeah. Let me preface this. Dariush was rocked in that fight. Big time.
Exactly. But no, even besides all that, the whole first round, he had Jakar Close's back, Damian Maia style, up against the cage where they were standing. And with a guy like Scott Holtzman, who he's a big, strong guy for the weight division, he's a decent counter wrestler, but he's a guy who's been known to fade as the fight goes on. It's kind of tailor-made for Benil Dariush to win, because unless Holtzman just cracks him with a big bomb and knocks him out, like, again, the one weakness that you were alluding to, Benil Dariush can't take a shot all that well. It's one huge problem. It's like, remember when everyone used to say Dustin Poirier doesn't have a chin when he was at 145? And then all of a sudden one day he has like one of the greatest chins ever. And now it's like, okay, he had this great skill set. Now he's got the durability to go with it. Look how good he is all of a sudden. If Benil Dariush could somehow just overnight get an insane chin, he might never lose again. Like, he's that good. He's got a great jab to switch stances, southpaw. Excuse me. Great on the mat. Again, I can't stress that enough. He is primarily a grappler, and I think the Drew Dober fight really proved that because Drew Dober did classic Drew Dober. Kind of was fighting him sort of like Paulo Costa does, get him up against the cage, throw those big body shots, really push the pace, push the pace. Benil Dariush kind of Floyd Mayweathered him. He weighed it, was really sound defensively. Don't get cracked in the chin. Just keep on thinking. And then once he found his opening, he was able to get the takedown, get a really nice iron bar, and stop a guy who, right now, people are really high on Drew Dober. That was the same fighter who fought Benil Dariush, and he was able to finish him in the first. So I think the ceiling for Benil Dariush is top five, probably. It's hard to say champ because, you know, you got Tony Ferguson, Khabib, Poirier, Gaethje. Like, 155 is probably just the greatest division ever. But a guy who, skill for skill, can match up with some of those guys in the top of the division. I'd love to see him fight Charles Oliveira one day. I think that'd be a great fight. And Scott Holtzman, a guy who, normally it's a guy outside the rankings, who you don't know all that well, who's really young in their career, that really young, hungry lion moving up the division, trying to fight sort of the older veteran who's been there for a while. It's the complete opposite, though. Benil Dariush, only 31 years old, still kind of in his prime, is still evolving fight to fight. With Scott Holtzman, I can tell you exactly what he's going to do. He's going to move forward. He's going to throw boxing combinations, never go for a takedown, and hope that you're going to kind of engage with him in one of those boxing-esque MMA fights. But it's just, Benil Dariush is way too smart for that. One of the more cerebral fighters out there. I think he is going to be able to get a takedown at some point. And the difference between Jakar Close is submission defense, at least, and Scott Holtzman is Scott Holtzman not going to be able to put up that kind of fight. If Dariush has his back for any period of time during this fight, he's going to finish him. There's no doubt in my mind. He trains with Coach Rafael Cordero, Fabricio Verdum, a guy who's very famous for going from the back to an arm. He's got a lot of different finishes from there. And I think Dariush, we could see something similar. I think he's going to be able to get the back. I think he's going to be able to get a submission. This is my lock of the week, even though the durability of Dariush is a little concerning in this fight. But I just think skill-wise, he's so much better than Scott Holtzman in every area of MMA.
Are we bringing them back? Because listen, let's say this now. Maybe you're new to Fight Night Picks. You're part of the 10,000 plus club, and you weren't there for the first 10. Which is kind of crazy, and that's a humble brag, and I'm sorry. I apologize, Canadians. But listen, our locks of the night, Matt, were Molly McCann to beat Tyler Santos, and Mark Jacasey to beat Rafael Fiziev. So I'm an honest guy. I like to say that now. Scott Holtzman, like you said, he's a good boxer. He can switch things up. It's just weird to see a guy that's 34 years old, almost 36 years old, almost 37. I mean, yes, we have Francisco Trinaldo, the ageless wonder, and he's probably still going to kick it at like 83 in the UFC's lightweight division. Maybe he's got to, you know, move up to 170 because the weight cut was tough against Jai Herbert. But if you look at this fight, Scott Holtzman, yeah, he can box with some of the guys in the division. I mean, we're going back, you know, we're getting close to 3 years ago when he beat Daryl Horcher. Then he beat Alain Patrick. But you're not hearing a lot about Daryl Horcher or Alain Patrick. Then he loses to Nick Lentz by decision. It wasn't a good fight. If you want to go back and watch it, by all means, be my guest. Then he knocks out the maestro, Dun Hyun Ma. Dun Hyun Ma had fun fights in the UFC, but not a lot of great Dun Hyun Ma fights.
And Ma was able to drop Holtzman in the first round, too. That's, again, Holtzman, he's a good fighter, but he's very basic in his skill set. And you're fighting a guy who's extremely dynamic and can do everything. So nine times out of ten, I'm going to have to pick the more dynamic guy.
And he beat Jim Miller, but again, it's kind of tough to tell what you're going to get with Jim Miller night in, night out. And that was earlier on this year. For Beneil Dariush, we're talking a long time ago. I can bring it up just for fun. He beat Jim Miller back in 2015. So it's been quite some time since Dariush fought him. This is where it gets really fun. The odds, they're strange to me because Dariush, the minus 165 favorite, Scott Holtzman coming back, plus 135 underdog, over on Tapology at a 727 votes, 92% going with Beneil Dariush, 50% saying he's going to win by submission. Now, it might sound like we're going with the crowd, we're going with those votes. Matt hasn't even seen these, so there's all that. But I really do think this is, and we've said it before with Hack Press taking on Munoz, but this is really Beneil Dariush's fight to lose. I think he's better in a lot of respects. The only way I see Holtzman coming in and doing any damage is, again, he lulls him into that boxing type of fight where Jakar Close did it to a certain, you know, regard, but his wrestling's quite good. So you always had to worry about Jakar Close kind of working that in, going for the takedown. I don't worry about that as much with Scott Holtzman. He's not like a big, thick type of fighter at 55 like a Jakar Close. And I think for Dariush, it's again, it's looping shots versus straight shots. And if you look at it right now, Black House or Kings in Southern California, they're having tons of success. This is one of those guys that I see having even more success. And I think it's Dariush's fight to lose, and he's going to win. Well,
and again, for like future opponents, when I think Beneil Dariush, I think guys like Gregor Gillespie, Kevin Lee, Charles Oliveira, like guys who are big names, recognizable guys, you know how good they are. When I think of Scott Holtzman, I think how many more fights is he going to have until he retires? Because again, he's an older guy. It's not like he's going to make this big push up to fight Khabib one day. So it's interesting that they're giving Holtzman this fight, I should say, because Dariush feels like he's always one win away from being back in the top 15 like he was a few years ago. And Holtzman, to me at least, seems like he needs 5-6 wins together just to crack and get a number next to his name. So again, lock of the week, Beneil Dariush. I'm even going to go as far as to say by submission. I think he's that much better on the ground than Holtzman, and I'm pretty confident with this pick.
Matt, both going with Benny and the Jets. Beneil Dariush to get the win. You're not going to want to miss the rest of our predictions for the card. We've got 12 of them, including an extended look at our main event between Derek Lewis and the boa constrictor, Alexei Olenek. Keep it locked in with Fight Night Picks, Matt. And as we always say, let's get into it.